When students meet the reactivity series for the first time, it might be fairly common for them to investigate some reactions of magnesium or zinc and some other metals with hydrochloric acid, for example, producing some hydrogen gas. They may even have a go at reacting some calcium with some water, also producing some hydrogen gas, and have demonstrated to them the reactions of the alkaline metals. One thing that I like to do to really strengthen this connection between the reactions with the water and the reactions with the acid is to explore in a little bit more detail what's going on with magnesium. And this is where the reaction of magnesium with steam comes into play. So if you leave magnesium for a period of time, you can actually collect some hydrogen gas off of this, but you can see the reaction that I'm showing here that was collected over about a 24-hour period. We were able to produce a sensible amount of hydrogen that we could then burn off. You can see the phenolphthalein also there changing colour, indicating that we're producing some hydroxide ions in the solution as well. But of course, when it comes to sort of showing a reaction, you may not necessarily have the ability to immediately cut back the following day for some students, and this is where being able to speed things up by working at a higher temperature and reacting the magnesium with some steam can help us out. You can start by wrapping up a 10 to 15 centimeter coil of magnesium into a coil about a few centimeters in length and about half a centimeter to a centimeter in diameter that will neatly fit inside your tube. Do be aware, of course, that you don't leave sections of long magnesium ribbon around in the lab. There's potential theft risk associated with that as well. We're going to be using a Pyrex or borosilicate boiling tube to make sure that it can withstand the high temperatures that we're going to be operating at. And once you get the experiment ready, make sure that both audience and demonstrator are protected by safety screens. You should be wearing splash-proof goggles for this experiment. This experiment, by the way, should never be attempted with more reactive metals like calcium or the alkali metals, and definitely not with magnesium powder either. Once you've got your kit set up, you'll need to get your Pyrex boiling tube and insert some mineral wool down into the bottom, and you can then soak that with some water. Now, I find it kind of handy to actually load this from an angle and then use the pipettes to load from the top of the mineral wool as I'm doing so. That gives me an idea of whether or not it's being close to being saturated at that point. Once the mineral wool is wet, you can then push in your magnesium coil and add a bung to the end. Through the end of the bung, there is a small section of glass tubing that's protruding about 2 centimeters to make sure that we can safely light the magnesium afterwards. With the students positioned 2 meters away, wearing eye protection, and with you wearing your splash-proof goggles, you can now begin to heat directly below the magnesium with a heating flame from a Bunsen. It'll take about 30 seconds for the magnesium to light, and once it does, immediately move the flame to the water. You can now light the end of the glass tubing to show the evolved hydrogen, linking up the experiment with that of the other metals from earlier. Sometimes, once you finish the experiment, you'll notice the borosilicate tube will crack. Even if it doesn't, the glass will still be severely weakened and should not be reused. Rather than reusing it, rinse in at least 500 cm cubed of water. You might get a few bubbles or even a pop as magnesium silicide reacts to produce pyrophoric silanes, and then you can then dispose of this in your regular glass disposal. So a classic experiment, magnesium with steam. Give it a go, and we'll see you in a couple of months to have a look at some jelly babies.